Hello, Guitar Society and music fans. I'm Phil Heywood. I want to give a big thanks to the Guitar Society for not canceling their season and putting it online. It feels really great to have a gig on the calendar, I tell you. And thanks to Steve Call for at Wild Sound Studio for pulling this all together for us. I'm going to start with a tune that was written by Booker T. Jones of Booker T. and the MGs, the guy who wrote the great groove Hammond B3 tune, Green Onions. It was very early in his career when he wrote that. And a few years later, he wrote something else also named after a vegetable called My Sweet Potato. It wasn't nearly the big hit that Green Onions was, but it did catch the ear of English guitarist John Renborn, who recorded a really nifty arrangement of the Booker T. Jones tune. That's one of the things I've been working on recently, is learning John Renborn's arrangement. So I'm going to try it right here. Wasn't quite the ending I wanted, but almost, thanks. This next tune is a Leo Kottke piece written really early in his career. It was on that album that has become known as the Armadillo album, in which he played his 12-string guitar with finger picks, a great big huge sound that knocked all of us teenagers and 20-year-olds off the map. And There are tunes there that still really ring my chimes, and I recently went back to that record and tried to learn this one. It really is a 12-string piece, but it's very hard to play on a 12-string, especially if you're not wearing finger picks anymore and you don't have the guitar that felt like the guitar that was the guitar of your dreams, which he had at the time before it was stolen. I haven't heard Leo play this song in decades, and I've been enjoying it on the 6-string, actually. It makes it into a little more of a classical-sounding number, perhaps. Don't ask me to explain the title. It's called The Last of the Arkansas Greyhounds. Let me check that bottom string just one real quick time. Thank you. This next tune is something I wrote. Again, it's nothing new. I recorded this about 20 years ago. It's a tune I call Days of Reckoning, which we've learned is a title that just doesn't want to go obsolete. To end the set with an old folk tune, American folk tune. Thank you. Thank you.